Hi viewers, welcome to Commissioner of Collegiate Education, Government of Telangana. I am Veeraya Sheelam, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Government Degree College for Women at Nalgonda. Today we are going to discuss about ecology topic. Before the enter of in details, one quote belongs to environment, that was given by Mahatma Gandhi. Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed. So earth is provide everything. Earth provide enough to satisfy every man needs, but not greed. Greed means selfish. So earth for only giving requirements, need to the man, but not greed. If the earth utilizes for greedy selfishness, in that moment remaining people are goes to suffering. Lack of that natural environment beneficiaries. So must protect the earth. In that moment, every person goes to satisfy. This quotation was given by Mahatma Gandhi. Course details, BSc, third year, fifth semester, paper Ecology and Biodiversity, topic Ecotypes and Ecods. So these two words are contrasting words. Ecotypes means morphological, they are morphologically similar. Ecods are genetically similar. So ecotypes are morphological similar. These are genetically similar. Ecotypes are morphological similar but genetically differ. Ecods are genetically similar, morphologically differ. So these are completely contrasting words, ecotypes and ecods. In the given environment, such type of the plants are growing in natural conditions. First we are going to ecotypes. Eco means ecological, ecological types. Ecotypes definition: a population of individual of a species with genetically adapted to its particular environment is called ecotype. So population of individual species which are genetically adapted to particular environment is called ecotypes. So ecotypes are finally adapt to the one environment. Some genetically, not a simple, genetically adapted, which plants are genetically adapted to a particular environment, they are called ecotypes. First time the ecotype term coined by Turison, 1922. Turison, ecotype term. In 1922, Turison explains the origin of ecotype as a species with ecological amplitude that shows variations in morphological and physiological characters in different areas. So morphologically and physiologically variations. Finally, in different areas. It is the opinion of Turison. The differences are related to the habitat variation. That plant species are grown in different habitat variations. The differences are not due to plastic response. Plastic response means morphological and physiological. So the organism behavior, if belongs to morphological or physiological, that is called plastic response. That plastic response to change the environment, but are actually due to the natural selection of locally adapted populations from a pool of genetic variations available in species. So these are the some changes in a particular population. That population always try to change either morphologically or genetically. So morphological, these are similar species. Ecotypes means morphological similar. Morphologically similar species always try to change in their genetical genome level based on that surrounding environment. According to Turison, an ecotype is a product arising as a result of genotypical response an ecospecies to a particular habitat. Just before, genotypical response. They require genetical variation. They need, that is called evolution. So always that species are try to genetical variation, genetical response to a surviving to belongs to particular habitat. So the ecotypes are always try to genetical responses to surviving to near particular habitat. Ecotypes are interfertile. Hence, they are placed in the same taxonomic species. So, ecotypes are interfertile. It is one of the character. They produce hybrids. These plants are genetically distinct. Means genetically differ to each other. Ecotypes means genetical distinct species are called ecotype. But morphologically similar. Genetically differ to each other. When genetically differ, such plants are producing hybrids. So hybridization takes place in between the species. That hybridization by interfertile, interspecies. So hybrids are producing. Sometimes these are permanent and irreversible also. These hybridization process is permanent. Genetical distinct is permanent. That hybridization process sometimes takes place as irreversible manner. New ecotypes are occasionally formed by hybridization. So ecotypes means genetically varied species, various species. Already they are genetically various. Therefore, the cross in between genetically various species is called hybridization. For example, Spartia stricta versus Spartia alternifolia. When natural cross takes place in between them to produce a hybrid. Therefore, one new offspring hybrid is producing. It is the Spartia townsendi. Spartia townsendi. It is offspring a hybrid. Spartia townsendi is too stronger, which eliminates both the parents from their natural habitat due to its greater adaptability. So hybrid is offspring is shows hybrid vigor. Which character? Spartia townsendi is living in that habitat. Where townsendi living in that area, parents are eliminated. Even parents are eliminated that area. Only Spartia townsendi has survived in that area. That character is called greater adaptability. Spartias townsendi get greater adaptability. Therefore, that species survived in that area rather than parents are eliminated. So, it is very stronger than parents. Due to the mutations, so mutations, mutation means variations. And another one is natural recombinations. Produces small gene pools. So mutations and recombinations are gives evolution or variation. That is called small gene pool. In that segregated population, which become more adapted to the habitat. So genetically various species. So mutations gives genetically various species. Natural recombinations means genetically variations. Therefore, gene pools are formed that segregated populations which become more adapted to the habitat. So here, these are adapted to the habitat. More adapted to the habitat. Why more adapted to the habitat? Mutations are one reason. Recombinations are another reason. They produce small gene pools in segregated population. Segregated populations means isolated populations. We become more adapted to that habitat. They survive until thousands of the years because mutations and genetical recombinations. One more character, polyploidy also one of the reason. Polyploidy often leads to the formation of new ecotypes. Polyploidy also favor, induces formation of new ecotypes. Ecotypes means morphologically similar, genetically differ or distinct. Different ecotypes of particular species may differ in their edaphic or biotic or microclimatic requirement. So ecotypes are formed in different. That different ecotypes are, that species are formed maybe edaphic related, biotic related or microclimatic related. They retain their characteristic features even when planted in neutral habitat. So ecotypes retain their characters even at neutral habitat. Each ecotype is the result of selection by its environment and has become specially adapted for a particular set of conditions. So every ecotype need a particular conditions. They need particular conditions. Small population of an ecotype, when it is isolated, will tend to become less variable genetically. So less variable genetically. Less variable genetically means genetically dissimilar because of inbreeding, contain few biotypes. So you observe in small population, few number of biotypes are formed. Biotypes means ecotypes. So small population always produce small number of ecotypes. Why they produce small number of ecotypes? When they are isolated, less variable genetical, so the genes are not vary in between the species because of inbreeding. The main reason is inbreeding. Always inbreeding gives the lines are, pure lines are coming, but genetically they are similar. So inbreeding gives similar. The similar are genetically which species are similar, they are called less number of ecotypes. They need morphological similar, but not genetical similar. Inbreeding gives genetical similar, identical offsprings. Inbreeding gives identical offsprings, genetically identical offsprings. Therefore, less number of ecotypes are formed. In contrast, in large population, so it is a contrast character, in large population, more number of ecotypes are formed. So, larger population with more biotypes or more ecotypes likely to include some individuals that can withstand adverse conditions or adverse circumstances and that can advantage of new variations in the environment. So, here observe, in larger population, more ecotypes are formed. At the same time, it is advantage to the new variation in environment. So it can adjusted. Even in adverse condition, such ecotypes are surviving at new environment. Larger ecotypes are formed, even survive at adverse conditions, although new environment also they can support to the ecotypes. So it can support to the ecotypes or biotypes. So larger population decide to produce larger number of ecotypes. That larger number of ecotypes always try to survive in adverse circumstances, even though they survive in new environment. Different ecotypes are observed in the nature, which are climatic ecotypes. Climatic ecotypes. Edaphic ecotypes. Climatio and edaphic ecotypes. Altitude and latitudinal ecotypes. Physiological ecotypes. Now, one by one, here ecotypes. We observe here the plant name Aquila lanulosa. Aquila lanulosa. In Aquila lanulosa, this is one plant. These are the flowers. The plant height is maybe above 50 centimeters, approximately 80 centimeters height. So it is the height on y-axis, 50 centimeters, it is 100. So nearer 100 means, for example, 80 centimeters height. The next plant also flowering stage. The diagram shows flowering plant. It is nearer 60 centimeters height. It is also nearer 60 centimeter height. It is the 40 centimeter height. It is 30. It is 20, 10, 20, again 30, 40. So in a single area, almost 100 mile or in a given particular area has different levels of the height plants are visible. In a same species, a single species exhibit different, genetically different plant species are visible. These are the ecotypes. So the same figure given here, ecotypic variation in the height of Aquila lanulosa grown in uniform garden. A single garden has these type of the plants, but all plants are genetically differ, but morphologically similar, but height is different. This pic taken at California. So in distinct, in a big garden, a single garden has these type of the ecotypes. So ecotypes means genetically various, genetically distincted, but morphologically similar. Many type of the plants are grown at a single garden, which are genetically distinct, but morphologically similar. All the plant roots, stems, leaves morphologically give a identical structure, but height is different. The flowering also similar here. At the same time, seasonally, those flowers are, the blossom is occurred. So it is another example, ecotypes. So here, these flowers are yellow color. These are orange color. so it is a mixed color. So 2-3 varieties are there in this. Morphologically similar but genetically differ. Therefore, the genetical differ gives different colors. But a single species exhibit 2-3 varieties, morphological varieties. They are called ecotypes. The first one, climatic ecotypes. These are developed in response to differences climatic factors like that light, temperature, water. Climatic ecotypes are formed by the differences availability of light, temperature and water. If the plant get different light, temperature and water, the such type of ecotypes are formed. They are called climatic ecotypes. Example, Leontodon autumnalis. Autumnalis, autumn is a season. Only that plants are gives flowering in autumn season. Therefore, the name also came on the season, autumnalis. Leontodon autumnalis. This plant exhibit climatic ecotypes. Adapic ecotypes. These are developed due to differences in soil factors like soil mature condition, excess or deficiency of nutrients. So these are deciding mature content, excess nutrients or deficiency nutrients. These create adapic ecotypes. So in a single species, many type of the plants are created in a particular habitat. Many type of plants are created by the availability of mature, availability of excess nutrients or deficiency nutrients. These adapic factors are decided to producing many types of ecotypes. They are called adapic related ecotypes. For example, Lindenbergia polyantha, Euphorbia thymifolia. In these plants, many type of ecotypes are formed when mature, excess or deficiency of nutrients. These are decided to the forming of different type of ecotypes formed in among these two genus. They are called adapic ecotypes. Climato and adapic ecotypes. Climatic means light, temperature, water. Adapic means soil related, soil mature or nutrients. Combined together, sometimes these two factors are decided to form ecotypes in a single species. These are arise due to the influence of both climate and adapic factor. Here adapic means soil. Example, Cenchrus ciliaris. In Cenchrus ciliaris, approximately 4 type of the ecotypes are observed. That 4 types are formed based on the availability of light, temperature, mature, soil mature and nutrients. 4 different ecotypes of Psychometrella patens are visible here. Here these 4 varieties are morphologically similar but genetically differ to each other. Some of the genetical differences are there among these 4. Next one, fourth one, altitudinal and latitudinal ecotypes. Altitudinal means height. So height is considered as above the sea level, considered as altitude. Latitude, from the equator of the earth planet towards the pole side. So these are the latitudes, from equator to pole side. Altitudes and latitudes, both are decided to forming or originate of new biotypes. They are called ecotypes. Such type of ecotypes are called altitudinal and latitudinal ecotypes. These are developed in relation to change in altitude and latitude. For example, Pinus. Pinus plants are growing at only mountain area with cool area. That cool area come under temperate zone. The temperate zones are across the above 40 latitudes, 40 degree. Across the 40 degree latitudes come under cool zone, temperate zones. So your latitudes are decided to which type of vegetation grow, which type of the species are grown on Earth planet. At the same time, altitude also. Above 4000 meter height, almost that region looks like cool climate. That is also called a temperate region. So the 4000 above meter altitude gives pinus plants. It gives a support to the particular vegetation because temperature is very less. Therefore, pinus is growing in that areas. Cassia tora. It is very common wild plant. Even in our area, during the rainy season, they are grown as a wild plant and weed plant. Angalis arvensis. These three plants are shows altitudinal and latitudinal ecotypes. So every species exhibit 3-4 varieties. They are called ecotypes. Next, physiological ecotypes. These are developed due to physiological changes like photoperiodism, nutrient uptake, water absorption. So mostly photoperiodism is decided to the production of, to the origin of ecotypes. They are called physiological ecotypes. Example, Boutlona cartipendula. This plant produces two type of the plants, which are short day plant and long day plants. Boutlona has two type of the varieties. One is short day plant, another one is long day plant. It can flowering at short day period and long day period, both. Therefore, morphologically similar, but the flowering season, flowering time is different. When light is available below 12 hours, that is short day plant. Long day plant means above 12 hours. When light is available above 12 hours, day of length of light, that is called long day plants. So in the species, two type of the plants are producing. Means there are two type of the ecotypes. But the two ecotypes are morphologically similar, genetically differ. Such type of ecotypes are called physiological ecotypes. Significance of ecotypes. Significance. Formation of ecotypes helps the species spread to new areas. So spreading of new areas. Because a single species has 3-4 varieties. That 3-4 varieties are easily spread to in different areas. The species can survive. The species can evolve easily. Spreading, distribution, everything is easy. Genetically differed species, but morphological similar. Cultivation of economically important plants in climatically and edaphically different places are possible due to evolution of new ecotypes. So evolution is possible in these ecotypes, which show adaptation to the new habitat and increase their productivity. So here, adaptation to the new habitat and productivity. So it is a direct link. Adaptation is one important feature. Adapt to any habitat. Therefore, that is called new habitat. So adaptation to any habitat and simultaneously increase the productivity, increase the yield. These two are very important for surviving of ecotypes. Now, ecards. Ecards, another name, ecopenes. substitute name ecopines. Ecards are population of individuals of a species having same genetic makeup. This is important word. Remember, it is helpful in entrance. Same genetic makeup means genetically similar species. Then having different morphological, but having different morphological characters. Here morphological characters are different. Genetical characters are similar. Response to the particular environment. Such species are called ecards. Ecards are ecopines. These two terms are important. Similar genetic material, different morphological characters. So morphologically they are differ. Genetically they are similar. Simple you by heart or remember, similar genetic. Genetically similar species are called ecards. Usually genetically similar species are exhibit different morphological characters. They are called ecards. They are also surviving in the nature. They are essentially produced from a homogeneous genetic stock. So when these are same genetic makeup, therefore homogeneous genetic stock is producing. Homogeneous genetic stock. It is also necessary for a improving developing population. For example, human population. For the increasing of human population, the homogeneous genetic stock is required. The homogeneous genetic stock formation dependent on similar genetic makeup. So which species are genetically similar, they are create a homogeneous genetic stock. The modification are somatic and are environmentally induced. Modifications are somatic. These differences are visible in only somatic level. Somatic level means body, only external, as well as environmentally induced. These variations are not fixed. These are temporary variation as well as reversible variations. These are not heritable. Only the species get these all type of the variations in its lifespan. Which are variations? Somatic variations. That variations are not fixed as genetically. These are temporarily variations as well as reversible variations. These are not heritable. So when changes are takes place in a species, consider as ecard, that ecard get more variations but not permanent, but not heritable, only temporarily genetical variations visible in the species. The variations appear in the number and size. The variations appear in number and size of vegetative parts. Which are vegetative parts? The number of flowers or size of flower. Erectness means sometimes the stem is erect or prostrate or creeping. That is also decide. Growth, habit, reproductive vigor. These all are variations. But these all variations are only temporary but not heritable. Ecards may be differ to such an extent as to give different specific names. Different specific names, which are Haplopappus venutus. It is a one species. Another one is Haplopappus decumbens. These two species exhibit these characters. Which are? Which characters are exhibit? These two are Haplopappus venutus and Haplopappus decumbens exhibit variations in number, in size of vegetative parts, flowers, erectiveness, growth habit, and reproductive vigor. These all characters are visible in both plants. these two are ekards, genetically similar but morphologically differ. Ramakrishnan 1959 studied in Euphorbia hirta, commonly it is known as Patsabotla chettu or Raman pille plant. So Ramakrishnan studied in this Euphorbia hirta. It is a biodiesel plant. It contains latex. Latex contains hydrocarbons. So therefore it is called petro plant. It is a small herb plant growing in a grassland, usually in rice fields. It grown in rice fields. It is two type of growth is visible, two type. One is Euphorbia hirta growing at dried soils, dried and hard. Soil is dried and hard. It is one variety. So Euphorbia hirta growing at dry soil or hard soil. Another one grow at footpaths. It is the second type. But Euphorbia genus is same, hirta species is same. The same species grown in two areas. One is dry soil, another one is footpaths. Footpath means we are walking, walking margins, walking road. He was observed that which is growing at grassland and dry soil area, that is growing as prostrate as well as profusely branched. Prostrate, the growth phenomena, growth style is prostrate and branched, while the footpath form is compact, small leaved and cushioned. Where Euphorbia hirta growing among the footpath, that is looks like compact with small leaves and cushioned. But the same plant grown at grassland area, which is prostrate and fully branched. This is the main difference. It was observed by Ramakrishna. These two are ekards, genetically similar but morphologically differ. The differences disappeared when two forms were grown under identical and neutral habitat. If we provide same habit or neutral habitat, in before Euphorbia hirta grown at dry soil, in another one is among the footpath. If the two type of the plants are placed in a new habitat, what will happen? In new habitat or identical factors are available, in that moment the plant grows a similar growth visible in between two plants. So here two differences, the differences are disappeared. Only the dried soil gives that phenomena. So here Ramakrishna observation, observed grassland, prostrate. Prostrate means the plant Euphorbia hirta plant grows such type of manner. This is the prostrate style Euphorbia hirta plant. At the same time many branching also visible in this. So numerous branchings are visible where Euphorbia hirta growing dry soils. The dry soil growing Euphorbia hirta exhibit two characters. One is prostrate growth with numerous branching, but in second one footpath form. The footpath form plant has growing compact with small leaves and cushion like, so the leaves are very close, therefore looks like cushion. It is the main difference. Genetically both are same, but morphologically one is prostrate, another one is small-leaved cushion-like. It is the morphological different. But both are same species, Euphorbia hirta, Euphorbia hirta. If these two species are placed in a neutral habitat or identical habitat, what will happen? What will happen? The differences are disappeared. The both are growing in same manner, erectness with branching, numerous branching. It is a common variety. So neutral habitat decide the virginal character of the species. Thank you everyone who are watching this video.